What is there to say about the Boy Scouts of America?
Stalwart and steady and true.
See how his guide can shoot you down, yet there's no substitute.
Forceful and ready to defend the red, white, and blue.
Well, in 2020, they filed for bankruptcy because... Actually, that's not important. All you need to know is the way Boy Scout advancement works. It's actually quite simple. You see, you start as a Cub Scout, and there are six main ranks. Lion, Bobcat, Tiger, Wolf, Bear, and Weeblos. What even is a Weeblo? Then comes Boy Scouts, where you start
first class
and second class, but it's
you have to do the basic swimmer test,
but not the swimming merit badge unless
Eagle
you don't do hiking or cycling.
Badges.
Or they're not all required, because you'll need 14 merit badges. 14 merit badges, not enough. No, you need 21, plus community service, plus the Eagle Scout project. Religious building with required uniforms, your pledge to start each meeting. No, it's not a cult. And that's Boy Scouts, basically. I started Cub Scouts when I was around 7, and look how cute I was in this picture. What happened? My pack needed a Cub Master, so my mom was like,
"Hey, Ryan's dad, you should do it."
Then my dad was like,
"No, Ryan's mom, I will not."
And my mom was like,
"Ryan's dad will do it."
And from then on, my dad was the Cub Master, and I was in a pack with William. Yes, that William. And we built birdhouses. And raced cars our parents built. I mean that we built with no help. And life was good. Towards the end of that, I moved to Pennsylvania, got my Arrow of Light, became a Boy Scout, and my pack was now a troop. Now, not to boast, but I was a part of Troop 37, which gave me a very firm foundation because of their incredible leaders who— No, I'm lying to you. Troop 37 absolutely blows. Okay, I'm sorry, that was a little disrespectful. Troop 37 absolutely blows my mind with how it's even allowed to call itself a Boy Scout troop.
Hey, what gives? I thought scouts were supposed to be respectful. What happened to that?
A scout is trustworthy. It's right there. In an effort to avoid doing things, Troop 37's leaders gave 100% of the responsibility to the older scouts, who in turn gave 100% of the work of cleaning the entire church every week and not doing anything Boy Scout related to the younger scouts, me. In fact, after years of dedication towards Troop 37, I only made it not even halfway to Eagle Scout through my Boy Scout journey. And a rule about Boy Scouts is that you have to make it to Eagle Scout by the time that you turn 18, or else it doesn't happen at all and you don't get another chance. Don't get me wrong, I made a couple friends in Troop 37. Like, since then I've been great friends with Brian, Drum for Life, Nine, Myers, and a bunch of other people. But I just wasn't going anywhere. By the end of 2018, with just around 3 years left to complete my entire Eagle Scout journey, I was only, like, not even halfway there. It got to the point where becoming an Eagle Scout started to seem unattainable. It was far too much to possibly do in this short amount of time. Or should I say, plausibly do in this short amount of time. But one thing to note about me is that I'm a closer. I don't miss. I absolutely just pop off. When the going gets tough, I'm tougher. Like, when I start something, it doesn't even matter how I begin, because boom, I just succeed in the end. Also, my mom said she was going to sign me up for basketball if I didn't try to do Boy Scouts. I switched troops out of that dead-end Troop 37 and started with Troop 39! Troop 37 was dead to me. The leaders were better, the meetings were actually important, the events were better. Advancing to first class is the real hard part. I was good on merit badges and community service hours from everything I'd finished so far, but I needed a leadership position within my troop in order to have my Scoutmaster conference and advance to the next rank. But every leadership position seemed hard or boring. Like, I don't want to be a treasurer because I'd have to actually show up to events. Like, ew, yuck, cringe. The troop prayer person seemed easy, but there were too many younger scouts who wanted to do that. And as much as I enjoyed putting those puny little twerps in their place because I'm older and older equals better, I'm not a monster. But then I realized, wait a second, I could be. You see, within most big troops, there are patrols, which split scouts into smaller, more manageable groups. And every patrol needs a leader. So if I could convince my patrol to make me their leader, then not only is that first class done, but I also get the added bonus of bossing around little kids. And I was lucky, because within my patrol, there was only one other candidate who was eligible to become patrol leader. And that candidate was none other than the Ben Stout. If you've seen Mr. Fivehead on this channel, then you'll know that he is actually a really nice, genuine guy, and he will help anyone out whenever he gets a chance. So I capitalized on that.
I'm Ben Stout, and I think I would be an awesome patrol leader. No. Well, I mean, I think I could be an invaluable resource for all the scouts. No. Why not? I mean, I think I'd be pretty good at— You're busy. I'm not that-
You're too busy to help.
Seriously, I mean, I think the troops-
Give it to me. Let me have it.
Yeah, I mean, I guess you're kind of right. Yeah, you can have it.
And so anyway, I became a troll leader, and after about 6 months, I was able to move on to the next rank. Ironically, Ben Stout actually became the senior patrol leader, which meant he was actually in charge of me during that whole time, after he lost this little election to me, so that sucks. Also, funnily enough, I was actually the best patrol leader in the entire troop, which was great for me when the elections came around again, and it was no contest. The merit badges are what became a problem, because oh my Lanta, there are so many of them, and they take months to complete. Now let's do some quick math. At this point, it's nearing the end of 2020. The leadership position I have lasts until the middle of 2021, meaning that I literally cannot advance to the next rank until summer of 2021. My 18th birthday is March 19th, 2022, and I needed one more leadership position after the one I currently have just to fulfill that requirement. Add the months of merit badges and we're just out of time, and that doesn't even include the Eagle Scout project that I have to do. Mathematically, there is no way anyone should be able to get all of this done. At this point, Ben Stout was nearing his Eagle Scout. Brian, Drum for Life 9, already got his Eagle Scout, and I was pretty much the only one left. Implausible was genuinely starting to seem impossible. But if there's one person I know who's good at doing impossible things, it's me. So I girded up, I filled my horn with oil, and I just started popping off. Cooking, done. Railroading, done. Citizenship in the community, done. One by one, I was knocking out every single requirement in the book. And soon enough, I advanced to the final rank before Eagle Scout, which is a Life Scout. And this is where absolutely everything started falling apart at the same time. To advance from Life to Eagle, you need four things. A lot of merit badges, a lot of community service hours, another leadership position, and finally, your big behemoth Eagle Scout project, which you have to get like 100 people to approve, and I had to do all of this within about 9 months. The service hours were easy. I just went around my city picking up trash for literally 8 hours by myself along highways and stuff. Then I had to do like 1,000 hikes and campouts, and every single time I thought I got to the last one, the leaders would tell me, no, you actually have one more to do, so I do again, another hike or campout.
Get a load of this guy, someone who doesn't like being in the outdoors, but he's an Eagle Scout. Wow, what are the odds? I mean, he's so stupid, look at him, I can't believe this.
Wait, what's going on? Wait, wait, what are you doing? Wait, stop. Wait, no, I didn't mean it, I'm sorry, I didn't mean it. Wait, 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 what's going on? Wait, no!
I just needed one more leadership position, and it shouldn't be too difficult because I was so good at doing it those other times. I lost. I did not get the leadership position. You know who did get the leadership position, even though he had already become an Eagle Scout and didn't need it? The Benjamin Forrest Stout. Wow, karma really sucks. And now because of Ben Stout's selfish manipulation, I was not gonna become an Eagle Scout. Maybe on top of a couple other things. But it just really sucked because the finish line was finally in sight after years. And again, I didn't really care about Boy Scouts, but after you go so far and the finish line is right there and it's just right out of reach, it just really sucks. Because at this point, there is no time for another leadership position. By the time the next leadership position rolls around and I finish that, I will already be past 18 years old. I just started wishing that I hadn't been in Troop 37 for so long before switching troops. But then I realized, wait a minute, Troop 37. I'll be there for you. Okay, that probably didn't make much sense to you, but it made sense to me. You see, when I was in Troop 37, the older scouts assigned all of us younger scouts arbitrary leadership positions so that they didn't get in trouble from the leaders for not doing anything, even though ironically that's what the leaders did. Which means that even though it is technically a made-up leadership position by the older scouts, it is still a leadership position that I was forced to fulfill. Meaning that if I could just get my hands on the records of the Troop 37 leadership positions from like 4 years prior, then this might actually be possible. There was actually a way that I could do this.
Your call has been forwarded to an automatic voice message system. Your call has been forwarded to an automatic voice message system. Your call has been forwarded to an automatic voice message system. Your call has been forwarded to an automatic voice message system. Your call has been forwarded to an automatic voice message system.
That was genuinely my only chance. And now, due to the actual incompetence of the leaders of Troop 37, which is clearly why I'm so upset at Troop 37, I was not going to become an Eagle Scout. I reached out to them for weeks. Weeks. I reached out to every single leader. Never once did I get a phone call back except that one time when they said they were busy and hung up. There was no plausible way that I could be an Eagle Scout on time. I literally needed a miracle.
Are you ready for a miracle?
Ready as I can be.
Are you ready for a miracle?
Spirit set you free.
Are you ready?
Ready.
Are you ready?
Ready.
Are you ready?
Ready.
Are you ready?
Ready.
Are you
ready?
You see, when I switched from Troop 37 to Troop 39, one of my best friends in the world, Brian Drum for Life 9 Myers, decided that he wanted to switch too. His dad was the only competent leader of Troop 32, and his dad switched over to be a leader of Troop 39 as well. If I could somehow get Brian's dad to vouch for me that these leadership positions did exist to the main scoutmaster, Mr. Henning, then this might actually just be possible.
Ryan had a leadership position in Troop 37. Are you sure? Yes. What was it? I have no idea, but he definitely probably had one. Definitely probably. Okay.
That was it. Every leadership position, every stupid merit badge, every campout, every hike, every single requirement was done. Except for one. The big one at the very end, my Eagle Scout project, the thing that's going to take the absolute most amount of time. We were finally on to the last step of the process. It was time for
the Eagle Project!
Sorry, I tried copying Ryan Trahan there. I thought it would be cool.
Yeah, it's fine. I was going to be making a sand volleyball court at my church. Everyone was on board. Everything was going great. And then all of a sudden... Okay, so we might have to go back to the drawing board a little bit because I don't have 14 grand to drop on a project. It's not a huge deal. I mean, I still had a lot of time. Wrong. I did not have a lot of time. I had a very, very, very small amount of time to the point where it was literally approaching my birthday and I couldn't even think about how cool it would be to turn 18 because I was too stressed about trying to become an Eagle Scout before then. Time was ticking away. Tick, 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 tick. But with the help of literally every human on Earth that I know, we made a non-sand, a grass, volleyball court at my church. The borders are a little crooked, the paint is easy to come off, it saved us $11,000, and it looks really freaking good. Every single requirement checked off. It was such a relief that the only thing I had to do before my birthday was my main big Eagle Scout conference with all the rest of the people. I just go into a big room of people who are at the top of like Boy Scouts for my area, and I just talked to them about the stuff I did and my journey, and then after I talked to them, they're like, yep, you can become an Eagle Scout. It's the only thing I had left to do before I turned 18. And then I turned 18. And time was up. And I hadn't gone to the conference.
Wait, hold on. Where is it? Where is it? Oh, here. According to the official Boy Scout Rank Advancement Handbook, Section 8.0.3.1-1 states that an Eagle Scout Board of Review can occur up to 24 months after a Scout's 18th birthday. There's still time!
Now, I'm not saying that everyone on Earth can do anything that seems completely impossible. But I am saying that maybe impossible isn't always so impossible after all.